your friend.
Now back to me. Now look at your friend. Now back to me!
I'm in a lake!
I'm not in a lake. And this is the giving up density in mammals.
Optimal foraging is a theory that describes how long an animal should stay in one patch before searching for food elsewhere. One of the factors controlling this is self-safety. The last thing you want to do when you're sitting down to your tucker is being picked up by the claws of a falcon. Here we have three areas of cover, adjacent and almost equal in length and width. Let's go have a look. Short, mown grass. Perfect for a summer's afternoon, but is it good for foraging?
Ah, a bit scruffy and rough around the edges is how my hairstylist describes me. But it's pretty good for this environment as well, don't you think?
Right in the thick of it. Hopeless for working on my tan, but quite good for foraging, don't you think?
We expect to find that mammals spend more time foraging in areas of cover than areas of open. Take it away, girls.
Not a single hair was found. Useless. Well, what a fantastic day we've had. We found some great results, and some might say they're significant. We found that there's a lower giving up density in the thicker verge compared to that of the rough grassland and the smaller grassland. This was noticed by Bowers. We also found out that there's a higher giving up density during the daytime, which was another study done by Jacobson. Well, it's been really great having you here, guys. And I hope you join us next time when we will be looking at what effect that 3 hours in a pub does to 20 biology students. Till then.